Matt, what are some of the most popular visualizations that you see on Plotly?
Yeah, I think just kind of like the most often used ones because they're so familiar and also because, you know, they are kind of the classics are, we see a lot of line charts, bar charts, and scatter charts, and then a lot of histograms. But it also depends a lot on the user. Like certain users will only make bubble charts or only make, you know, heat maps. So if you scroll through our feed, you can see a lot of different types of graphs, but those are the most often made types.
Okay. And are there any unconventional chart types that you see?
Yeah, so one fun thing about Plotly is you can kind of invent your own chart types if you'd like to. We've tried to make it a really flexible environment for being able to use different languages or different programs to be able to draw your graphs. So we don't natively support maps, for example, but people have made maps using different packages from Python or R. People have made network visualizations, which we don't natively support, but someone has made a couple of those using a language called Julia. Mm. And then we've also seen people make sort of just their own out-of-the-box data visualizations that mimic some type of event that they'd like to show a visualization of that doesn't even necessarily have a name as a graph type.
Okay.